Okay. It's been a long time. My old motto, truth lives in the dark. I'ma help bring it to light. Been a long time since the ouch, this may hurt rant. But the rant today is inspired by Pastor Jamal Bryant in my hometown, Baltimore, Maryland. I don't know if it's true or not true, but it's something circulating again about another child and his emails and everything all over the internet. And somebody would probably think this video is critiquing Jamal Bryant or judging him. It's not. Like I say, the truth lives in the dark. Just a conversation I want to have tonight. Because I'm frustrated. This conversation is about the big lie. It's about the inspiration for my books. About the inspiration for my movement. Whether you like me or not, understand me or not, I'm going to keep speaking my truth. Until it's understood, because I believe it's my purpose. I believe it's my calling. Nothing about me is gimmicky. I'm not, what's the guy's name? I don't really want to take shots at people, but it's a guy named Tony Gaskins, and I see all the quotes shared by women and the high fives and preach and all of this stuff, and that's a part of the big lie. That's a part of why we judging Jamal Bryant. That's a part of why we judge men and women. Because we tell this big lie. We have this fairy tale. There's so much fairy tale stories told. Stories depicted in films, books, that are just not true. That completely contradict everything that you face in real life. One thing that anybody could say about my books, whether they agree or not, is going to talk about what you experience in real life. Just to kind of set the tone for what I'm about to do, I'm getting ready to kind of touch on and give an example of what I'm talking about, one of the biggest lies. Remember this song? And women love this song. Remember this. It's so funny running into you. It has to be 3 years since we last seen each other. Many flashbacks come to mind of the wild and crazy times we used to have. Nice jam too. And do it anyway. Yeah, he and he's a one woman man, and he's singing about it, right? And they loved it. They loved the song. I'm gonna be a one woman man. I remember women, that was the jam. Why? Because it fits into what a woman wishes a man would be like. And it's actually, I like the song myself, but men don't walk around singing that song. They might sing it because of the beat and it's on the radio, or maybe he's in love, you know, so he's feeling that song. But that's not something that he aspires to be like. That's something that he kind of falls into when he either finds God in his life or meets the woman that does it for him, and he discovers that side of him. He discovers it. But it's not like he naturally is that way. That's why I tell people all the time, like, hip hop speaks more about a man's natural makeup, his instinct. And R&B speaks more to fantasy. His natural makeup, his natural thoughts, whether he expresses it or not, is this. That's probably what Jamal Bryant was singing while he was doing what he was doing. See, the confusion, right, is that we have pastors, and I feel so sorry for pastors. They have a tough spot. They have a tough position. Real tough. Kind of like mine in a sense. The only thing is, I'm gifted. I have a gift of discernment. My perspective is keen. Like, I see things and can speak on things and analyze situations for what they are. The only difference between me and a pastor is I speak raw. I speak the truth, but I don't try to sell myself like my relationship is perfect. I screw up all the time. Actually, I thank God for my wife, whether we make it or not. See, that's how I talk, whether we make it or not. Because I keep it real. Like, we've been through a lot. My wife isn't always happy about everything I have to say. But one reason I respect that woman, one major reason, is because of the fact that she gets behind me doing what I do. And she understands that I'm just trying to tell the truth. The same truth I would tell my daughters. The same truth that I'm trying to share to the world. Of how men are, men think, men behave, how we really are at the core. I don't say anything is right. Like, people get confused. Like, I don't talk like a Steve Harvey. Like, no, because see, if you want a man and a man, I don't really kind of give rules and guidelines. I just kind of, I have a whole book, two of them, just keeping it 100 about how a man really thinks in situations, how he really behaves, how he really is. Nobody's doing that. You think they are, but nobody's doing that. That's why you get so shocked every time we hear of a Jamal Bryant or Tiger Woods or John Edwards or the Detroit mayor or the wiener. Or, I mean, the list goes on of things that men do that we keep going, oh, my God, I can't. And, like, that's why I wrote House Just May Hurt. There's a whole book of why. And I felt like it was necessary because nobody's saying it. Again, I'm not making it right, but I'm saying why. Like, Jamal Bryant is a man. He's a man first. That's why I said I feel sorry for pastors, because they have this gift. This gift of speaking. This gift of discernment. This wisdom. And it's attractive. And with that being attractive, they end up in tough spots because they are constantly fighting their natural makeup, natural desires, natural behavior as a man. So, in one sense, I could speak the word of God, like I could deliver it, articulate it, and he's good. Deliver it in a way that the masses can understand, keep it real, all of that, gifted. But then, because of my gift, I'm attractive. With me being attractive goes to my book, The Life of an Alpha Male. With me being attractive, every situation I'm in, women are kind of throwing it at me, giving it to me, whether they do it blatantly or whether they do it subtly. Like, they don't know. They're just coming for help or whatever. But really, at the end of the day, they're attracted. Like, we need to talk that people are really naturally attracted to each other and end up in awkward situations because the power or the emotion of sex is powerful. When are we going to keep it 100 about that? Are we going to act like these millions of affairs, millions of premarital sex, philandering, it's just accident or these people have problems? Instead of keeping it real, like, men and women, man, is dangerous anytime, especially if you're attractive, especially if you're gifted, especially if you're powerful, because you can end up in a situation. He's always going to have to fight that. It's like a gift and a curse that he has. And there's other men on earth that have it as well. Is women that have it. I know we have situations like Bill Cosby, well, allegedly, where women are drugged and stuff. That's a whole different story. Other than that, there's a lot of situations. Men and women screw, man. They do. They do, for different reasons. For different reasons, people are attracted to each other. For different reasons, people have affairs. For different reasons, people are promiscuous. For different reasons. We all have our reasons, but the bottom line, how animal nature kicks in, like that attraction, the pheromones, the chemistry, it's all real. And we act like we can't talk about it. Like, we flirt, we do all of this inappropriate stuff, and then we go, I can't believe he. Come on. Come on. I'm not shocked every time an article comes out from Jesse Jackson, from when I watched Malcolm X with Elijah Muhammad, the great prophet, all these men, because I understand. I understand. Like, my wife is bad. Yeah, I'm saying it. You can critique that too. She is. Nice body, all that. I'm not, because I understand men, I'm not one of those guys that trip when we walk through the grocery store or when we walk somewhere and I can see the man like purposely come down the aisle or look down our aisle and then happen to walk this way so he can get a peek. I get it because I know how he's naturally made up, because I'm made up that way. I get it. I know what I know what men constantly fight. And women. But society has also made women have to kind of even downplay it. Or when they're attracted to a guy, like, I feel like we would get a lot more accomplished if we keep it 100. Why are we so shocked again? Or why are we sharing these articles like, oh, you guys worship Jamal Brown? Stop worshiping the man and listen to the message. Do that with me. Do it with anybody. And then for all the men that critique him, public figures and the masses, then we find out your skeleton's in your closet. So shut up. Because you know the girl, and I saw the picture of the girl. If I saw it right, the article I saw, she was nice. She was real nice, actually. We gotta act, we can't say that out loud because he's a pastor. I remember when I was speaking in a church, and yes, the church invited me to speak because I realized as many people that judge me, the people that are attracted to me or that receive my gift, they respect my honesty. And I was telling the church, I said, I was telling them why I wrote a chapter called Sex Is Not Love and why I broke that down. And I was telling them about how men are with sex. And I talk a lot about sex and ouch because that's what men normally want to do with women. That's what they normally think about. That's why I talked about it. But I break it down. It's not that black and white. But I was talking to the church about Ayanna Van Zant. I think that's how you say her name. Who cares? I don't really care for her because I think she's kind of for show. But that's another thing. I don't like that for show stuff. But anyway, so she was interviewing this pastor that had kids. So we're not talking about Jamal right now. We're not going to put the highlight on him. She was talking to a pastor on her show. And he had kids in the church. And so she was interviewing him. His wife was there. And she was breaking it down. And she was giving him lies. And when I say giving him lies, like society does, making him tell that lie about why he did it. And so I was saying this to the church. I said, I'm watching this. And she's going, you did it because you're insecure, aren't you? And you're really childlike. And she's breaking down all these reasons. And he's sitting there like, yes, I am. And the whole time I'm watching the show, I'm thinking, like, will you tell that woman you liked it? You enjoyed every bit of it? And if these women were throwing themselves at you, you were in power, they actually look good, and break it down to her. It's not making it right, but say why. Like, if we, the one thing I say about the Bible that I love, it breaks down why. It's raw. And that's why I write that way. That's why every story that I tell raw. That's the reason why I sip, because I want my raw, true, instinctive emotions to come out. I don't want to be politically correct in anything that I do. I don't. I want to keep it real. I want people. I don't want to people to applaud me or my meme shared or my quote shared because I make you feel good. Or that's right, David. Tell them. Tell the men they need to. Yeah, it's a lot I needed to learn. There's a lot I'm still learning. I'm hard-headed. Dealing with people, and this goes for men and women. Dealing with men or women that don't have to settle and can kind of, and they're intelligent, they kind of have their pick of the litter. That's a tough person to deal with because they're spoiled in a sense and they're used to getting their way. Like, keep it real. See, I said, like, I never mind talking about my flaws. I never mind talking about my flaws. So that's why you could share my videos and say, well, he used to mess with my girlfriend. However, it's probably true. And does that mean whatever I'm saying doesn't make sense? Is it not validated? Is it no truth to what I'm saying because of that? That's why I don't care. I'm going to keep speaking the truth. I'm going to keep writing the stories that I write, the stories that I tell. I don't care if I'm writing about, I don't know. Anything that I write about is going to be raw. That's one thing that's going to be consistent for me. It's going to be the raw truth of what you experience in real life. Not fairy tale stories or not having you hoping for something that doesn't exist. I'm going to try to break down what does exist to kind of give you wisdom. Shout out to Jamal Bryant. Pray for him. Hopefully his situation is right. Maybe it's true or not true. Pray for the young lady as well. She's just as accountable. Hopefully we can stop this big lie, man, that we talk about relationships in a way, this fairy tale way that doesn't exist. We talk about relationships and fairy tales in a fairy tale manner, yet divorce rate is over 50%, leaning towards 60. Second marriages, 67%. Almost all third marriages fail. But we keep talking like it's all sweet. Everybody has an A+. Everybody sharing posts about they slay and they're this perfect catch and the man that gets me is going to be a lucky man. And come on. No, they're not. The last five don't like you. Same thing with the dudes. The last five women are sick of you. Stop it. Men need to stop acting like it's okay to do the things they do because they're a man. And this is my, I guess, PS or bonus, but women's attitudes have ruined just as many relationships as men cheating. I've been wanting to say this for a long time now. Women's bad attitudes has ruined just as many relationships. Their attitudes and lack of understanding of a man have ruined just as many relationships as men cheating or their neglect and selfishness to women. We all need to be accountable for our part. We all need to try to do better. I welcome conversation. That's why I love the emails. I love the inboxes. I love doing the forums. I love doing the women's conferences. I love speaking. I love it because for me, I like to learn. So I like having a conversation. I don't get all emotional in a conversation. I come to say my point, to say my perspective, and then once I say it, I'm listening. I'm like, tell me, because I want to learn. I want to learn the female species as much as I can. I want to learn the opposite sex. I want to learn what I'm missing. Everybody needs to take that attitude. Everybody. I see men, there's men that's bitter too. And then I see men judging women as well. Like, man, I could go on for days. It's too many topics that I could touch. But I do. I see men judging women and telling women that they need to cover up and they need to do all of this stuff. But yet, they're breaking their neck to turn it. The woman is not covered up. So you lying. Do you like a covered up? You not. Like, pick one. Keep it real. Like, I know for me, I like a woman to dress sexy. I like it. My attention span is too short. I like to be excited. Man, I was just made hurt. If y'all want to know the real, again, I'm glad I didn't talk about Jamal or blast him. I didn't want to, but his that thing shared today inspired me that I felt that I needed to do another post. Eat the meat and throw the bones away from what I'm saying tonight. These are my two books. Ousters May Hurt. This is just a bunch of real facts about men, how they think, how they move in different situations. The stuff that's in here is unbelievable. Things that people don't talk about out loud, but it's all in here. Everything that you do. And then Life of Alpha Male. Story. An erotic novel, but it's deep. He had to learn some things. I had to learn some things. That's what inspired me to write this one. Love y'all. The truth lives in the dark. I'm sipping, so I tell the truth. I love this. I was born to do this. I know it. Check out my books. I swear, the realest thing you ever read. Later.